Doing a PhD is a constant roller coaster of light bulb moments and turns.
The aim of a PhD is to create an original contribution to knowledge, and that is a big ask.
I'm now a doctor in philosophy. I suppose I'm the world's leading expert in female munition workers' dress in Britain during the First World War, which is really strange to say, and it feels slightly unreal, but also completely amazing and a great responsibility.
PhDs are fantastically diverse, and that's one of the things that we really try to drive in particular is diverse ranges of approaches to a PhD project. It can take any form, literally any form.
Generally, you have a viva at the end, and you usually present a thesis which you have to defend. Sometimes with different types of PhD, you have a kind of portfolio or a practice that you also present that gets looked at by a supervisory team.
If you're doing a PhD in the humanities, in most cases, you have to spend a lot of time in the library. You have to spend a lot of time just you and the text.
They're all dealing with human culture. They're either dealing with artifacts, history, written work, and it's all looking into who we are and the very nature of human identity. And that helps us bring into context our own lives today and in different areas of society, helping us relate between people who differ from us.
They are really thinking about how we frame the world and how we live in the world. And by looking at the way others have constructed things, one realises all sorts of things that are very, very helpful to surviving in the contemporary world.
In my case, I'm trying to understand the relationship between people and the environment itself, which of course nowadays is quite a very important issue to address. And it's not just understanding the behavior of people in the past, but also in present and looking forward for the future.
Looking at things from the past, especially when it comes to women's work, it's really important to me because some of the women who have more confidence were definitely fighting to get equal pay, which today is still a contentious issue.
I always think that art is the heart of the nation, and it really is.